We have seen the common base configuration. In that common base configuration, base is going to be grounded with respect to the input as well as output output circuit side. Okay. Please tell me whether my screen is visible or not. Is it visible? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. This is the common base configuration, that is both the PNP type of transistor. I am using common base configuration only for PNP type of transistor as well as NPN type of transistor. In this, some resistance are maintained across input circuit side as well as output circuit side. Across this emitter, one resistor is maintained, that is RE, and across the collector, another resistance is maintained, that is RC. For a sudden flow of current makes the transistor into the destruction state, so in order to avoid that condition, we are going to maintain these resistances here. Normally this resistance, input resistance, is high and output resistance is low normally, and this AC input signal is applied. AC input signal is applied and it is indicated like this. And with respect to this emitter terminal, I am going to apply some biasing condition, that is input side, it is going to be a forward bias condition. By providing this biasing condition, the emitter base junction is forward biased. This emitter base junction is forward biased, yes. And the collector base junction is reverse biased, as we know this one. Similarly, that is applied to PNP transistor also. That is, emitter is P, let it be P type semiconductor material is connected to positive and N type semiconductor material is connected to negative. Then it is in forward bias condition. And collector is the P type semiconductor material is connected to negative and N type semiconductor material is connected to positive. Then we can call this as in the reverse bias condition. Then this transistor is in the active region. It is going to be operated in active region. In the active region, the transistor is properly operated. Our transistor is going to be in the properly operated region. Okay. This is the properly operated region. And common means it is going to be grounded. It is going to be a base is going to be grounded, and I can call this base terminal is common between input and output circuits. Okay, this is the basic construction of common base configuration. Thereafter, we will see the amplification factor alpha. The amplification factor alpha is the output current by input current. That is, here output current is, here the input current is IE. Input current is IE and output current is IC. This flow of current, emitter current is flowing inwards, whereas collector current is flowing outwards. Therefore, I can take this current as output current as negative, whereas inward current as positive. From that, the multiplication, the amplification factor is given by, if I am not at all applying any sort of AC voltage to the circuit, then I can treat that signal is in the DC position. Therefore, I can given the notation as alpha DC is equal to minus IC by IE. This is output current by input current. In this way, it is that this alpha quantity gives the measure of the quality of the transistor. It is going to give the measure of the quality of the transistor. Its value is going to be lies between 0.9 to 0.99. And similarly, if I am applying some AC input voltage, then this alpha will become alpha is equal to minus delta IC by delta IE. Change is going to be notated with respect to AC type of amplification factor. Okay. And the magnitude here, the flow of current is given by IC is simply, we can call this as, from this relation, alpha is equal to IC by IE. That implies IC is equal to alpha IE. We know that the emitter current is equal to IC plus IB. That implies IB. I would like to know the what is the base current. IB is equal to IE minus IC. I will substitute this IC term here. I'm going to substitute this IC term here, then this, then that equation will become IB is equal to IE minus alpha IE. That implies IB is equal to 1 minus alpha into IE. Okay. And total collector current, we would like to find out what is the total amount of collector, what is the total amount of current is flowing across the collector terminal. That collector current IC is equal to alpha IE plus ICB0, where alpha IE is the majority carrier current flow, ICB0 is the reverse minority carrier current flow, like that we are going to consider here. Okay. And thereafter, that collector current is given by IC is equal to alpha into this IE. We know this IE term. This IE is given by IC plus IB. I will substitute that IC plus IB here plus ICB naught, and I will rearrange the alpha terms on the left hand side. Then 1 minus alpha into IC is equal to alpha IB plus ICB naught. That implies IC is equal to, only in terms of the final equation is going to be only in terms of alpha in terms of alpha, then I will take this collector current as IC is equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha into IB plus 1 by 1 minus alpha into IC B naught. Okay, this is the relation between alpha and beta. We will just discuss this relation between alpha and beta in the next sessions. Okay, don't worry, till this point just derivation part is important. All the final collector current equation is given by this one. Okay, and the characteristics of common base configuration. In this common base configuration, this is simply, I will tell very simply, please memorize that one. You will replicate this same process in your exam also. Okay, just for input characteristics side, in order to find out the input characteristic side, first we are supposed to go to output side. Go to the output side, vary this VCC with the help of potentiometer R2, then variation in this VCB will take place. I will set it to some 5 volts. Initially, some constant voltage 5 volts is set. Constant 5 volts is set here. That is VCB. VCB constant 5 volt is set, then leave the output terminal, come to the input circuit side. Again, leave the output terminal, come to the input circuit side, vary this VEE. With the help of R1, vary this VEE with the help of R1. Okay. Then the variation in the IE, the change in IE, as well as change in VEB is going to be takes place. Variation in IE, as well as change in VEB, is going to be change in the these two values will take place. By taking these two values with the help of some tabular column, I will note down those all the readings from the range 0 to 30 volts by varying this VEE. Like that, I am notated IE here, as well as VEB here. Okay, by notating that IE as well as VEB, I will plot one curve here. I'm going to plot one curve. That curve is just like this one. I'm going to plot that curve, that is VEB with respect to VEB as well as IE. What is the constant voltage applied here? Constant voltage applied here. Tell me anyone. What is the constant voltage? What is the parameter we put constant here? That is?
VCB.
Yes, right. VCB is equal to 5 volts. I have set this VCB is equal to 5 volts. Same process repeats for another set of curve. In order to obtain another curve, I will take the same set of readings, that is input in order to obtain the input characteristics, go to the output circuit side. Where is this VCC? Then VCB is set to some 10 volts. Then leave the terminal. And again come to the input circuit side. Vary this VEE with the help of potentiometer R1. Then variation in this IE and VEB will take place. Then I am going to note down those readings in the tabular column. After noting down that readings in the tabular column, I am going to plot this curve here. That curve is going to be plotted. That is VCB with respect to the 10 volts. Similarly, VCB is equal to 15 volts. VCB is equal to some 7 volts. Like that, we can make here some change over in this VCB voltage. Setting of this VCB is also going to be takes place. We can obtain any number of curves. By setting the VCB as some constant voltage, we will obtain any number of curves. Please. You set it as this VCB by taking this different values, different constant values VCB from 1 to 20, like that we can take any number of set of curves can be obtained by this input characteristic. The input characteristics curve can be obtained here in this way. Okay, we will see. This one, the same process is theoretical format is given here. From this input characteristics curve, I can obtain the two points here. I am going to plot the two points here. I can project the two points upon this graph. I will obtain this point as well as this point. I will obtain delta VBE, as well as I will project these two points in this direction. I will obtain delta IE. Okay. In this manner, I can project two points. I can obtain delta IE as well as delta VEB. From that, I can calculate what is the input resistance here by making constant voltage VCB is equal to some constant voltage. Okay, and this is the slight increase in the emitter current IE with increase in VCB due to the change in the width of the depletion region across the width, slight increase in the, just a minute, I will erase this one. This point is very important. Please listen. There is a slight increase in the emitter current IE. Emitter current IE ne increase chaste by increasing the emitter current in with increase in VCB due to the change in the width of the depletion region of the base collector base junction. The width of this region. Let me draw that one. This is the PNP type of transistor or NPN type of transistor. Emitter terminal, collector terminal, base terminal. Base terminal, collector terminal. Okay, here there is a slight increase in the emitter current. By increase in this emitter current IE, by increase in this emitter current IE in VCB due to the change. VCB means voltage applied across this emitter base and collector. I am going some voltage here, that is VCB. VCB is obtained here. VCB due to the change in the width of the, by change in this VCB, by change in this VCB, the width of the base collector region is going to be varied. Base collector region, that is the depletion region, is going to be varied here. Width of the depletion region of the collector base junction under reverse bias condition, it is in reverse bias condition, then that region is going to be varied here. The depletion region is going to be varied. This effect is known as early effect. This effect, we can call this effect as early effect or base width modulation. ఈ రివర్స్ బయాస్ ని ఇట్లానే ఇంక్రీజ్ చేస్తాం అనుకున్నాం. ఈ విసిబి వోల్టేజ్ ఇక్కడ ఉన్న విసిసిని ఇంక్రీజ్ చేస్తూ విసిబి వోల్టేజ్ కూడా అట్లానే ఇంక్రీజ్ చేస్తూ ఉన్నాం అనుకోండి. ఈ రివర్స్ బయాస్ ఏమవుతుంది? రివర్స్ బయాస్ కీప్స్ ఆన్ ఇంక్రీజెస్. Then that width keeps on increases and it will reaches to the, this collector region reaches to the base region. This collector region reaches to the base region, and there is a, this base region is going to be, the width of this base region is going to be affected. That condition is known as base width modulation. A base low base region lo a reverse bias atla increase avutam valla a base region lo entante width increase avutam shrink avutam jarugutund anamata due to that reverse biasing effect. That effect we can call that effect as early effect here. This early effect is so important. Okay, and we will discuss this more deeply further in the subsequent session. Okay, this is about base width modulation thereafter. And next one is output characteristics. Output characteristics, same output characteristics. Again, go to the input circuit side. You go to the input circuit side, vary this VEE with the help of R1, set this IE value as constant. Vary this VEE, first step. ఇది ఇప్పుడు మనకి ఫస్ట్ సెకండ్ స్టెప్ కదా. సెకండ్ స్టెప్, వేరీ దిస్ విఈ అండ్ సెట్ దిస్ యాజ్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఐఈఎస్ సమ్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఐఈఎస్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు సెట్ దిస్ సమ్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఐఈఎస్ కాన్స్టెంట్ లెట్ ఇట్ బి దట్ ఈస్ 1 mA లైక్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు సెట్ హియర్ ఆఫ్టర్ సెట్టింగ్ దిస్ వన్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు లీవ్ దిస్ ఇన్పుట్ సైడ్ and I will go to the output circuit side, vary this VCC with the help of R2, then variation in this IC as well as VCB is going to be noted, then change in this IC value as well as change in this VCB value is going to be noted with the help of some tabular column. Okay, with the help of some tabular column, I will get some set of readings. That set of readings I will note it here. I am going to note this set of readings. From that set of readings, I will plot this graph. I am going to plot this graph here. First one is, initially I am going to set this VCB is equal, this IE is equal to 0 mA. I will get some small amount of readings here. That small amount of readings I am going to note it here. I am going to note that readings, that is by varying this voltage, VCB voltage, I will note down the small amount of current flow. That current flow might be, it is approximately equal to 0 mA, like that 0 mA. Below the 0 mA, I am going to obtain like approximately 0.01, 0.02, like that I am going to obtain some small amount of current flow below this 0 mA garu. I am going to take that graph. I am going to take in the reverse bias condition. Both the junctions are in reverse bias condition. I can get the dashed region. I can get dashed region means that is cutoff region. I am going to obtain cutoff region. That region is indicated here. That small amount of current flow is taking place. That small amount of current flow is mainly because of minority carrier current flow. That current flow is given by ICB0 here. Okay, similarly, saturation region means both the junctions are maintained at maximum level, that is forward bias condition. Therefore, I can treat this region as saturation region. Though I am not at all giving out any sort of voltage, that is VCB, below this zero, I am getting some small amount of current flow. That small amount of current flow is from minus one volt in between 0 and -1 volt. Like that, I am going to obtain some small amount of current flow. That flow is given here. That flow is obtained. That is indicated like this. Okay. Similarly, and VCB is increased. IE is set to some constant current value. I am notating some values here, that is IC as well as VCB. From that, from these tabular column values, I will plot one curve. That plot is, let it be this curve. I am going to plot that curve. That curve is this one. I am going to plot that curve. That curve is this one. And approximately, IE current is equal to that constant current. Constant current IE is equal to approximately equal to IC here, that collector current. Okay. Similarly, I am setting the emitter current to 2 milliamps. Thereafter, I am obtaining the constant flow of collector current. And again, across the input circuit side, I am setting IE is equal to 3 milliamps. I am obtaining another set of curve, that is 3 milliamps curve, that is constant. IE is equal to IC, it is constant. I will go up to 10 milliamps also. I can obtain the following set of curves by setting this IE value as constant current. That is with respect to the some low end of current flow, that is from 0 to some maximum amount of current flow can be given here, that is up to 6-7, like that we can obtain that different set of curves in the output characteristic side. Okay, output characteristics, in this way you are supposed to plot the output characteristics here. This output characteristics consists of three regions. Those regions are below this 0 milliamperes, one region is there, that is cutoff region. And left hand side of this active region, we can call this region as saturation region. And in between, the constant flow of current is taking place. That constant flow of current, that is emitter current, is approximately equal to collector current. That region, I am going to treat that region as active region. Okay, active region. I am going to treat that region as active region. In this way, you are supposed to tell the operation of output, operation of a common base configuration, that is output characteristics. Okay, just a minute. That is a theoretical part. And again, by projecting two points on this VCB, as well as by projecting two points on this IC, I can obtain delta IC as well as delta VCB. From that, I can obtain the output resistance here. That output resistance is given by R0 is equal to delta VCB by delta IC. That making IE is equal to some constant. By making this IE is equal to constant, I can obtain input resistance nunchi, input to characteristics nunchi input resistance vastundi, output characteristics nunchi output resistance vastund anamata. That is the main point. Okay, as IE increases, IC also increases. Thus IC depends upon the input current IE, but not on collector voltage. Hence input current controls the output current. Adega first diagram lo base configuration vesinappudu draw chesam, input current IE, IC current flow ki ekkuga ee IE current ikkada flow avutundi anamata. 98% flow of current is mainly because of emitter current. Okay, that is the point here. IE is flowing across the collector current. That collector current is IC is equal to alpha IG. That is collector current is dependent component enti, collector current dependent component to IE. here. Therefore, transistor requires a small some current to drive it. It is called as collector. This is called as current operating device. Small amount of current is required to drive the transistor into the working state. Then that condition we can call that it as current operating device. Transistor breakdown occurs when the collector to base voltage VCB increases beyond certain limit. Breakdown ఎప్పుడు వచ్చింది transistor కి ఆ VCB voltage అంటే VCB voltage is across the collector side by increasing this VCC to VCC is increased beyond certain limit and VCB is going to be in the reverse bias condition beyond that point that junction is going to be breakdown here. That junction breakdown may takes place. That junction breakdown condition we can call that breakdown condition. Such breakdown is known as punch through or reach through antamata. That condition is known as punch through or reach through. That means reaching the collector region, reaching the there is a variation in the base region due to the reverse biasing condition applied across the collector and base terminals. By that reverse biasing, all the minority carriers are flowing across the reverse bias condition. Those charge carriers will punch through or reach through the both the junctions here. That junction across that collector base junction, the charge carriers are punch through or reach through. That condition is given here. Here, emitter base junction forward biased, potential barrier decreases. This is the basic simple overview I am giving in short notation. And the collector base junction reverse bias, this is reverse voltage increases, potential barrier also increases, space charge potential also increases. That means base width modulation. Base width em avutund appudu base unna, for example, base width oka 10 micrometer undi ee reverse bias valla adi 5 micrometer atla avutund annamata. Base width is going to be decreases and the base reaches to emitter. Ee base em avutund atlaga reverse bias ayipoyi emitter ki reach avutund annamata. Ee emitter ki reach avutam valla em antam ante aa width of that base is going to be varied due to that reverse biasing effect across the collector and base. ఆ బేస్ వల్ల ఆ బేస్ రీజనే ఎమిటర్ దాకా వచ్చేస్తుంది అన్నమాట. దట్ కండిషన్ ఈజ్ నోన్ యాజ్ బేస్ విత్ మాడ్యులేషన్. దట్ బేస్ రీచెస్ టు ఎమిటర్ జంక్షన్ దాకా ఆ బేస్ రీచ్ అవుతుంది అన్నమాట. అండ్ ద బేస్ విత్ డిక్రీజెస్ బికాస్ ద బేస్ విత్ మాడ్యులేషన్ ఆర్ లిల్లీ ఎఫెక్ట్. దిస్ ఈస్ బేస్ రీచెస్ ఎమిటర్ జంక్షన్, ఎమిటర్ అండ్ కలెక్టర్ షార్టెడ్. అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది, ఎమిటర్ అండ్ అది బేస్ అనేది ఎమిటర్ దాకా వచ్చేస్తుంది అనుకున్నామా. ఇప్పుడు బేస్ కలెక్టర్కి అటాచ్ అయింది కదా, అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది, ఎమిటర్ అండ్ కలెక్టర్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు బి ఇన్ ది షార్ట్ సర్క్యూట్ కండిషన్. దేర్ ఫోర్ ఐఈ ఇంక్రీజెస్ ర్యాపిడ్లీ. దట్ ఈస్ బ్రేక్ డౌన్ కండిషన్ ఆర్ పంచ్ త్రూ కండిషన్. అట్లా షార్ట్ సర్క్యూట్ అవటం వల్ల ఏంటంటే ఈ కరెంట్ ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ కరెంట్ అక్రాస్ ది ఎమిటర్ సైడ్ కీప్స్ ఆన్ ఇంక్రీజెస్. That minority carriers flowing into the emitter side also. Therefore, that condition, that punch through or reach through effect of that minority carriers into the emitter side, and it will increases the emitter current. ఆ మైనారిటీ క్యారియర్స్ కూడా అక్కడ ఎమిటర్ దగ్గర కంబైన్డ్ అవటం వల్ల ఏంటంటే ఆల్రెడీ ఎమిటర్ కరెంట్ దగ్గర సమ్ 100% ఆఫ్ ది ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ కరెంట్ ఈస్ టేకింగ్ ప్లేస్ బై ది కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ మైనారిటీ క్యారియర్ కరెంట్ ఫ్లో ఫ్రమ్ ది బేస్ అండ్ ది కలెక్టర్. ఇట్ విల్ రీచెస్ టు ది ఎమిటర్ సైడ్ అండ్ పంచ్ త్రూ ఆఫ్ ది మైనారిటీ క్యారియర్స్ విల్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్ ఆర్ వీ కెన్ కాల్ దట్ కండిషన్ యాజ్ breakdown condition or punch through effect here. This is the across this base width modulation position there is a base width is going to be decrease. That depends upon the reverse biasing condition we are applying. ఆ రివర్స్ బయాసింగ్ కండిషను అంటే వోల్టేజ్ ఎక్కువ అప్లై చేసాం అనుకున్నాము, నెగిటివ్ వోల్టేజ్ ఎక్కువ అప్లై చేస్తే విత్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి ఇంక్రీజెస్. అదే రివర్స్ వోల్టేజ్ తక్కువ అప్లై చేస్తే బేస్ విత్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి decreases like that. Okay, here base width modulation is given by this emitter base junction forward biased, depletion region penetrates is less across the emitter. Idi for example, this is the emitter region, this is the collector region, and this is the base region. Depletion region across JE, idi JE position. Depletion region across this JE emitter junction depletion region across JE and depletion region across JC. These two are the depletion regions, right? And this is the depletion region. This is very thin. Why? Because I am applying forward bias condition. I am applying forward bias condition across input circuit side, that is emitter and base terminals. Forward bias condition is applied, whereas here reverse bias condition is applied. Okay, emitter base junction is forward biased, depletion region penetration is less across emitter. Penetration anedi depletion region penetration is very less across emitter, and the collector base junction reverse biased, depletion region penetration is more across collector. Depletion region ekkuga untundi collector daggara, emitter depletion region position takkuga undi ani cheppi cheptunnaru anamata. Okay, and this modulation of effective width, effective base width by the collector voltage VCB. VCB ని వేరీ చేస్తే ఈ వోల్టేజ్ అక్రాస్ దిస్ విసిబి, ద వోల్టేజ్ అక్రాస్ దిస్ విసిబి, ద పెనిట్రేషన్ దిస్ విత్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ద విత్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ బేస్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి వేరీడ్ హియర్. ద మాడ్యులేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎఫెక్టివ్ బేస్ విత్, దట్ మీన్స్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు ఇనిషియల్ కండిషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ బేస్ ఈస్ డబ్ల్యూబీగా తీసుకుంటాను అనమాట, ఇనిషియల్ కండిషన్. అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ది WB, that means this is the initial condition. This is the up to this one small reverse bias is applied. This is the width of the depletion region, as well as this is a change in, this is the large reverse bias. WB is given here, that width is given WB, and I can consider this, and again I am going to consider this entire region as metallurgical base width అనుకుంటాను అన్నమాట, metallurgical base width. And the concentration of these charge carriers is given by PN here. Okay, this is PN. Okay, and This is the modulation of effective base width by the collector voltage VCB is known as early effect. I am considering this width here. Normally this width is get provided. This is the large reverse bias is applied, that is WB, that width is WB. And small reverse bias is applied, and that width is given by small d here. The combination of this entire WB as well as d, and I am going to consider this as metallurgical base width. Mamuluga aithe ee small reverse bias apply chesinappudu mana base width inthe undannamata, small d untundannamata. Ade mana large reverse bias apply chesam anukondi, idi kuda combined avutundi ee d ki. ఇది కంబైండ్ అయ్యి అప్పుడు బేస్ విడ్త్ ఎంత అవుతుంది, ఇంకా పెరిగిపోతుంది అనమాట. ఇంకాగా ఈ బేస్ విడ్త్ ఇంకా ఇంక్రీజ్ అయిపోయి ఈ కలెక్టర్ రీజన్ కూడా ఎమిటర్ రీజన్ దగ్గరికి వచ్చేస్తుంది అనమాట దాదాపు. దెన్ దేర్ ఈస్ అ స్ట్రింకింగ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ బేస్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి టేక్స్ ప్లేస్, ద వేరియేషన్ ఇన్ ది బేస్ విడ్త్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి టేక్స్ ప్లేస్. దేర్ ఫోర్ దట్ కండిషన్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు ట్రీట్ దట్ కండిషన్ యాజ్ వేరియేషన్ ఇన్ ది విడ్త్, వేరియేషన్ ఆఫ్ ది బేస్ విడ్త్ ఈస్ టేకింగ్ ప్లేస్ హియర్. దేర్ ఫోర్ ఐ కెన్ కాల్ దిస్ ఎఫెక్ట్ యాజ్ ఎర్లీ ఎఫెక్ట్ హియర్. Okay, that is the point. This is very important phenomena, early effect in common base configuration. Explain about early effect in common base configuration like that, you may come across the type of question. Okay, and these are the parameters, transistor parameters. Those transistor parameters are, first one is input impedance. It is input impedance means these are the hybrid parameters. We will derive these hybrid parameters later on. Just for time being, just for memorizing sake, I am telling this one. Just it is defined as the ratio of change in emitter voltage to the change in emitter current. This is impedance. Impedance means normally Z is the combination of reactance plus resistance. It is the we can R plus JX, R plus JX, That is, impedance is the combination of resistance as well as some reactive component, reactance component, that is impedance. That here input impedance, that means input impedance means Z is equal to V by I. V by I, that is V by I. And input impedance here, what he is asking, input impedance here. Input means across input side, that is emitter side. Across emitter side, I am going to notate here, across input side, that is emitter side, that voltage is given by VEB. That voltage is across emitter and base, as well as across emitter side, another current is also there, that is delta IE. By making output voltage, VCB is equal to constant. That is, the HIB is equal to input impedance is given by HIB is equal to delta VEB by delta IE. This is the, in this way, we can calculate the input impedance here. Okay, this is just for memorize this one. We will go through in the, at the end of the all the units, we will go for this H parameter calculation also. How this H parameter, what is input impedance, what is output admittance, like that we are going to calculate. Don't worry, just for the time being, what is the parameter, transistor parameters, first parameter is HIB. Okay, that is the, that is voltage by current. That is voltage by current in the suffix notation is with respect to the input circuit side. Em undo adu chusukoni manam emitter kabatti, manam emitter kabatti aa voltage VEB antam, ade current kabatti current ki emo suffix E raastam anamata. Okay, typical HIB value for common base configuration is 20 ohms to 50 ohms. And next one is output admittance, HOB. It is defined as the ratio of Y, this is indicated as Y, that is reciprocal of impedance 1 by Z here. Okay, then it will become I by V. Okay, I by V, this is output side. Output side ante the in suffix lo em avali, collector terminal IC, as well as VCB. ఇప్పుడు అవుట్పుట్ సైడ్ తీసేటప్పుడు మనం ఏం ఎక్కడ పెడుతున్నాం కాన్స్టెంట్, ఏ టెర్మినల్ పెడుతున్నాం కాన్స్టెంట్ పారామీటరు, ఐఏగా కాన్స్టెంట్, ఇన్పుట్ సైడ్కి వెళ్ళి ఏ పారామీటర్ పెడుతున్నాం కాన్స్టెంట్, ఐఎమ్ మేకింగ్ దట్ కాన్స్టెంట్ యాజ్ ఐఈ. దట్ ఈస్ ద పాయింట్ గివెన్ హియర్. ఇట్ ఈస్ డిఫైన్డ్ యాజ్ ది రేషియో ఆఫ్ చేంజ్ ఇన్ కలెక్టర్ కరెంట్ టు ద చేంజ్ ఇన్ కలెక్టర్ వోల్టేజ్ విత్ ఎమిటర్ కరెంట్ కెప్ట్ కాన్స్టెంట్. With emitter current kept constant, that is given by HOB is equal to delta IC by delta VCB at constant current, that is IE is equal to constant. The typical value of HOB is given by 0.1 to 10 micro ohms here. Okay, more, sorry, not ohms, it is more, it is reverse of it. Impedance ki ohms units, ikkada reverse em avutundi, mo, reverse em avutundi, its units is mo. Okay, that is given here, that is 0.1 to 0.100 micro ohms, micro mos. Okay, next one, forward current gain, that is given by HFB. అండ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ వోల్టేజ్ గెయిన్, ఇప్పుడు ఈ టూ పారామీటర్సే మనకు కొంచెం ఇంపిడెన్స్ కదా, ఇంపిడెన్స్ అంటే ఆర్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు వి బై ఐ, అదే పారామీటర్లు తీసుకుంటాం. అడ్మిటెన్స్ అంటే రెసిప్రోకల్ ఆఫ్ ఇంపిడెన్స్, దీస్ టూ పారామీటర్స్. సిమిలర్లీ హియర్ ఫార్వర్డ్ కరెంట్, కరెంట్ గెయిన్ మీన్స్ కరెంట్ గెయిన్, నార్మల్లీ వీ నో ది గెయిన్. వాట్ ఈస్ గెయిన్? జీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు, గెయిన్ కెన్ బి క్యాలిక్యులేటెడ్, జీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు అవుట్పుట్ బై ఇన్పుట్. That is with respect to voltage annan anukundamma, with respect to voltage, then I can make this voltage. With respect to current means I can make this current, output current by input current, like that I am going to notate here. Okay, that may be, that gain may be in terms of voltage or current. That is forward current gain, it is defined as the ratio of change in, ఇట్ ఈస్, ఇది ఇప్పుడు ఏం చెప్తున్నారు, ఫార్వర్డ్ కరెంట్ గెయిన్. ఇప్పుడు మనకేంటి, ఈ అవుట్పుట్ ఎక్కడ తీసుకుంటున్నాం, అక్రాస్ కలెక్టర్ సైడ్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు టేక్ దిస్ అవుట్పుట్ కరెంట్, అక్రాస్ దిస్ ఇన్పుట్ కరెంట్, అక్రాస్ ఎమిటర్, అంతేగా. ఆ రెండు ఇక్కడ రాస్తున్నాం అనమాట, డెల్టా ఐసీ, delta IC by delta IE. I am rotating here. Okay. By making constant parameter, by making constant parameter VCB. VCB is set to some constant value, and I will obtain the delta IC value as well as delta IE value. Okay. In this way, we can calculate the HFB value also. HFB value also, we can calculate here. The typical value of HFB range is 0.9 to 1. 0.9 to 1 is the HFB value. And next one is reverse voltage gain. Reverse voltage gain that is given by reverse voltage gain is given by HRB. Reverse voltage gain ante enti? Idu ippudu forward current gain. Forward current gain ante normal thing. Whereas here reverse voltage gain ante output by input kada. Output by input. Idu normal condition. Ippudu em avvali? Input by output chestaru anamata. Input by reverse anamata. Voltage gain kaani output by input by output వేస్తున్నాం అదేంటి విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు వోల్టేజ్ దట్ గెయిన్ దట్ రివర్స్ వోల్టేజ్ గెయిన్ ఈజ్ గివెన్ బై జీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు వి ఇన్పుట్ బై వి అవుట్పుట్ ఇక్కడ ఇన్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ ఏంటి ఇక్కడ ఇన్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ ఏముంది ఎమిటర్ సైడేగా ఇన్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ ఉంది అదే ఇక్కడ రాసాం అనమాట దట్ ఎమిటర్ వోల్టేజ్ విఈ విఈ బి ఎమిటర్ వోల్టేజ్ ఎమిటర్ ఇన్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ అండ్ ఇక్కడ అవుట్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ ఏంటి విసిబి output voltage VCB. That means change in emitter voltage as well as change in collector voltage. That is notated with respect to the common terminal base. That is VEB and VCB. By setting the IE as constant, by setting the current, emitter current, setting the constant current, IE is equal to some constant value. Okay. Typical value of HRB is in the range of 10 power minus 5 to 10 power minus 4. Okay. 10 power minus 5 to 10 power minus 4. ఇది ఎగ్జామ్లో ఈ పారామీటర్స్ ఏమైనా ఒక 2 మార్క్స్కి 3 మార్క్స్కి అడుగుతారమ్మా మొత్తం 14 మార్క్స్కి ఇస్తారన్నమాట ఓన్లీ కామన్ బేస్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ ఓకే ది ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ప్లీజ్ గో త్రూ దిస్ వన్ అగైన్ హౌ ద సర్క్యూట్ డయాగ్రామ్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి కన్స్ట్రక్టెడ్ by constructing after constructing the circuit diagram with respect to the rendu nechukondamma rendu pnp as well as npn type of transistor ni apply chesi emitter current and base current and collector current how the flow of current is taking place in the pnp as well as npn first ee circuit diagram nu meer understand chesukunte you can easily understand all the circuit diagrams that is emitter configuration aina collector configuration you can easily understand that is easily understandable okay thereafter what is the amplification factor alpha and what is the base current we will derive base current thereafter total collector current across this one in terms of only alpha terms we will derive this collector current thereafter input and output characteristics of common base configuration that is input characteristics are plotted like this by the set of readings obtained from across IE and VEB okay from that set of curves and plotting that curve and I can obtain the input resistance here okay input resistance is going to be obtained in the input characteristic side there is one basic phenomena that basic phenomena is a base width modulation by increasing that reverse bias condition that base is going to be varied and it will that collector terminal will reaches to the base that collector terminal and base terminals are keeps on increases and it will reaches to the emitter side and there is variation in this base width takes place that condition is known as base width modulation or early effect condition okay and thereafter output characteristic side we come across three regions that is active region cutoff region and saturation region and from that output resistance can be given here from that set of curves I can calculate what is the output resistance also at the end of this one I have given some small notation here by seeing the small notation you can get all the basic idea regarding this entire process okay please go through this key points. By this key point, you can easily elaborately explain all the things here. Okay. Base width modulation is given like this. WB. This is the normal condition. It is the large reverse bias condition. Large reverse bias condition. This is the small reverse bias condition. I can get this width by increasing the large reverse bias condition. I can obtain this width with the position WB as well as D here. That we can call this as metallurgical base width. Okay. And the following parameters, that is transistor parameters, input impedance HIB, output admittance H0B, forward current gain, reverse voltage gain. Like this, you are supposed to write all these parameters and you will get 14 out of 14. Okay. In the next class, we will see the common emitter configuration. Okay.